So what do you, right? So like people reach out to you and just literally want like definitive answers. And you're just like, it's not really my place to give you, you kind of have to do it for yourself.
Yeah. My thing is always the same. Like there's a world out there. If you choose to get sober that you can only dream of, and it's a beautiful life waiting for you. And then I always tell them, you know, the first step that I would take is get the big book, which is the AA book, and start highlighting things that resonate with you and go from there.
Do you think it's different for every person in the sense that, you know, now we have this whole new definition of sober, which I never heard of before. Like I just watched the Demi Lovato documentary where she says like, she's California sober. Like she won't do hard drugs but she'll drink and smoke pot. And I'm not judging. I'm just saying like, do you think stuff like that works, or is it like sober, not sober, or is it really just, you think, different for everybody?
You know, I don't like to judge, but I actually think that that's super offensive. You know, there are people out there who work their ass off to never take themselves out of an take themselves out of reality and to never place themselves in an altered state. You know, they don't even, when they have a cold, take Dayquil or NyQuil. So to say that you're like California sober or this type of sober is extremely offensive, I think.
I never heard the term before until I watched.
No,
this.
And I'm not looking at you like you're the one.
Yeah, yeah, I know.
To me, I've been in rooms with men and women who have given up everything just to not pick up. So sober to me means that you are not taking yourself out of reality.
Right.
Yeah.
And California sober takes you out of reality.
It's not a real thing. You're not sober. If you're drinking or smoking weed, you're not sober.
I get it.